Good afternoon, everyone. In the class, in today's class of mechatronics, I would like to deal with respect to the industrial hydraulic circuits. In the previous session, we have a look regarding the pressure relief valves, PRVs, and its working in the circuits for considering the safe mode of operation for the actuators. That is nothing but the controlled strategy limiting the pressure and entry of the pressurized fluid under the controlled conditions by decreasing the pressure or else the dropping of the pressure. And in the today's class, we'll be discussing regarding the industrial hydraulic circuits. So you're already aware of these industrial hydraulic circuits that utilized for lifting the materials and in loading and unloading conditions and simultaneously the single unit of developing or imparting of pressure indeed to consider the multiple activities by the machineries in the industrial sector that creates less investment cost and increases the work efficiency at different levels. So here loading and unloading, nothing but transferring of the material from one place to another place, that is either from channel wise, that is from the left forward direction to move the heaviest loads from one place to the right forward existing places, or else indeed to lift the high weights from the ground floor to the top elevation levels, different elevation levels, and etc. So this creates this involves the creation of pressure in the case of this hydraulic system indeed to lift the weight from one place to another place. We can have an domestic example that the lifts will be utilizing indeed to carry the weights or else moving of the persons containing particular weights from ground floor to different elevation levels. That is first floor, second floor, third floor. In the apartments also we used to look the lifts. So casually you will be entering into that and the circuit will be connected towards it. We'll be pressing the so and so floor number. Gradually, it will be moving on to a particular number. So the electrical pulse, nothing but the solenoid control valves initiates the programming, which gives the signals to the hydraulic actuator and need to commence or extend with respect to a particular cage. So nominally, we will be considering that as an hydroelectrical system. Or else electro-hydraulic system in the modern apartments that we are being utilizing. So counterbalancing a weight will be supporting over there and a rope or chain pulley will be connected towards it. And that will be guiding with respect to a motor connectivity. And for that motor connectivity, a programming will be connected with respect to an electrical circuit. And that circuit involves the buttoning systems. And depending upon the switches that we are operating to move from ground floor to a concerned level of a floor, obviously it reads the entire electrical signals towards converting from electrical to the mechanical mode by creating or performing particular tasks at different levels and so on, creating a particular pressure in the hydraulic circuits to lift up the overall weights from ground level to a particular elevation level. So this is a task that is being performed in the case of general weight lifting devices or lifts that are being existing in the apartment that is utilized for the domestical purposes. Whereas in the case of these industrial bases used to carry the material from one section of work to another section of work, nothing but the cranes that are utilizing to lift the vehicles, lift some of the weights from a source position to towards the next position, and after completing a particular task in the that particular level, it need to be shifted from that place to then another place. And after the casting process has been considered, for example, considering the manufacturing industry raw material to a molding section towards the casting region, and after completing that casting, it has to be stored in the prescribed finishing section. After completing the finishing, it has to be stored in the warehouse. So these are the different stages of steps that are involving in the industrial field. Nominally, in almost all the industries, upon manufacturing, a particular criteria containing equipments or else the things, there involves a different sequence of steps. So indeed too, in between that sequence of steps, the material need to be transferred from one place to another place. Hence, this carries the different kinds of articles to be moved from one place to another place. And even the hydraulic system can be utilized for this conveyor belt transfer system also, operated with respect to the electro-based, just we have been discussed that electro-hydraulic system. Electrical signals will be given for the actuation of this hydraulic cylinder, which creates the movement or particular actions that either may be in the linear format or else in the rotary actions that will be as per the design criteria or else the design parameters that are being done indeed to transfer the material from one stage of work to the another stage of work. So instead of employing 10 members, the robotic device can perform well, by only one robotic device, it can perform that lifting of a particular huge amount of weight and carries from one place to the another place. Even it is highly impossible indeed to carry within constraint containing areas, at that particular positions also, you can utilize these robots. It is statically fixed over there for its continuous flow of work. So in such a conditions also will be utilizing. So here in the industrial sector, indeed to minute the economical factor and commencement of work simultaneously in two different working areas, commonly the pressure need to be supplied or is the pressurized fluids for the actuation purpose of the cylinder and piston arrangements, or else that can be occurred maybe in the hydraulic strategy or else the pneumatic strategy. So nominally we are discussing regarding the hydraulic mode of operations, because we are considering these oil reservoirs, pumps, etc. in the hydraulic strategy. So indeed to supply the common generated pressure of pressurized fluid to two different modes, or else single motor is installed for operating two different pumps simultaneously. Here a single motor that is being deployed here, that rotor is connected towards B section and towards A section, and both the pumps are being worked simultaneously. And bevel gear system will be connected within the motor that creates the clockwise for both the prime movers motors from the motor to these pumps, and hence the clockwise will be deploying here. And simultaneously towards the section of work, it sucks the fluid commonly from the oil reservoir from A pump and towards from the B pump, and allowable limitations, where the high amount of pressure is necessary and which one pump cannot be impart that particular pressure. For example, 1 HP motor and 1 HP, and this is a 2 HP motor which is having high capacity and pump is having less efficiency. It is 1 horsepower and 1 horsepower split into two different categories, which need to impart the pressure. Here it is 10 bar of pressure and 5 bar will be imparting by the pump A, and another 5 bar will be compensated with respect to the pump B. And if there is any additional pressure that is being entering from the pump A, a sequence valve is fixed over here, and other than that 5 bar, the additional pressure, if it has been entered, will be entering towards here, and this pressure sequence valves will be maintained, and additionally entered pressure will be getting dropped into the oil reservoir simultaneously from the pump B. Also the pump, the fluid will be, pressurized fluid will be pumping towards here, and the same pressure, the common connection has been connected towards this, because same pressure need to be maintained by pump A and pump B, because 5 plus 5 impartation of pressure, 10 need to be circulated towards the output channel to the concerned directional control valve, and that will drive with respect to the hose pipes connected to the cylinder and piston arrangement for commencement of its actions, either in linear motion or else in the rotary motions. Commonly in the B point also maintains the same pressure, set pressure. If it is furtherly increasing from the pump B, and simultaneously the sequence valve or pressure relief valve will be coming into the actuation and drains the additionally entering fluid, and commonly the certain fluid will be delivered at an desired pressure, that is 10 bar of pressure, to the output channel through the directional control valve. So this is the maximum conditions that are being maintained in an industrial sector, which the fluid at a desired pressure is being pumped by both the pumps which are in loading conditions, or else even in the single pump in an unloading conditions. So this is a loading condition by utilizing two pumps, or else unloading conditions you can utilize only one pump. So unloading doesn't deserve heavier pressure, because already imparted pressure, if you have been released also, commonly it can be released, or else the actions will be in counter side direction itself, because if the pressurized fluid is being drained back, automatically the movement which is having at a struck mode will be letting into the original position back again. If then compression has been existed with respect to a spring in the actuator, or else only a single pump can be utilized and back pressure will not be maintained, that is during forward direction pressure will not be maintained, and in the return direction only the single operating pump will be allowed indeed to operate the retraction stroke for the pump. So this is a technique that is utilized, that while imparting the pressure for moving the heaviest loads towards the forward direction, both the pumps will be in an actuation mode for commencement of activity. For return, after unloaded at that particular situation, there is no any load carriers. So hence there is no any heavy load to carry. Hence only single motor or single pump is enough in an unloading condition for its retraction process. Hence heaviest pressure need not be applied because of unloading condition of the wagon. Hence it is only single pump pressurization, nothing but 5 bar of, instead of generating 10 bar of pressure in the forward direction while the loading conditions has been maintained, can be reduced to a single pump, which can be enough to retract back the actuator to its original conditions in an unloaded strategy. This is the industrial way of sector, which minutes the operating cost operating cost, and next even commencement of activity, there is nothing, but the efficiency of work will be very much more in this particular strategy, and less in operating cost will be existing, and high efficiency, more output will be getting achieved. So coming to the point of next one, there is a reciprocating cylinder with automatic venting at end of the cycle. So we'll be having a detailed look regarding this reciprocating cylinder. In the reciprocating cylinder, it drives the common hydraulic system. It drives as like of a common hydraulic system. This is a system which is not necessary to hold the pressure at the end of the cycle. Because of the arrangement of the DCV that we have been given, after unloading, immediately without any external supply, automatically it itself take the extension stroke, which is connected directly to the secondary DCV that imparts or gives the signals for the retraction stroke to the main DCV. So hence that particular DCV directs the common terminology here, as in the diagram it has been given. The common connection will be maintained for the DCVs from the main supply of the fluid in the case of hydraulic system. And here the forward stroke initiates the actuator towards the movement of extension. And after the complete forward stroke of the extension, the end sensor will give the signals to this particular DCV that is connecting over here. And when this complete extension stroke has been existing from the actuator, it gives the signal of that to the secondary or from the secondary DCV to the primary DCV that the extension has been completed, and kindly change the position at the main drive. So it itself directs the second position indeed to commence the retraction stroke. So without any human involvement, nominally it will be completing its task in a prescribed strategy. Just we will be having a detailed look regarding this channels. So A is oil reservoir, hydraulic pump. B is an hydraulic pump, and C refers to E refers to the check valves. You see check valves, nothing but the non-return valves of the flow movement. And here D is a pilot relief valve, F is a two position electron hydraulic pilot operated four way directional control valve, is a DV, D is a non-return valve, and pilot controlled on 4x2 controlled, 4x2 controlled the pressure relief valve, nominally controlled pressure relief valve, and cam operated pilot valve. Is in G, cam operated pilot valve that has been existing over here is in pilot operated. When the pilot has been got extended, automatically cam will be moved with an extension. While it is being returning back, a spring which is compressed will impart the tension to for the lever to be in normal conditions before the extension commencement takes place is the consideration point. Nominally, we are considering this particular machinery. Just will be having a solenoid connection towards it. Here the solenoid connection of hydraulic solenoid connections. I think what utilization of hydraulic fluid for the movement, and this symbolic representation gives the imparts the condition that it is a solenoid connection. Solenoid is nothing but the electrical mode of operational circuit that you have already discussed in the previous sessions in the class of DCVs. So the DCV is operated, initial primary DCV is operated with respect to solenoid controlled This is a solenoid of a spring offset directional valve. F is energized, nothing but this. F, it is energized. Pump output is connected to the cap end of the cylinder. This is a cap end of the cylinder. The vent line drawn from the directional valve output connected to the cap end of the cylinder is blocked at the cam operated pilot valve G. So it is being driven from the output edge, which is commonly connected to the main DCV to the actuator, and next commonly connected towards the pilot operated DCV, that is G. Thus the vent port of the relief valve D is blocked, and hence vent valve D will be in blocking condition because it is will be energized upon threatening conditions. Hence this fluid will not be flow towards the backward direction because check valve has been placed out here, or non-return valve it is existing over here for the backflow movement. Hence it will not be any movement or any flow occurs towards this D, and hence D is blocked, and cylinder moves under the full pump pressure applied at the cap end, and hence this is the cap end, and hence the full pressure that is being imparting by this pump or motor is being driven with respect to a cylinder because there is no any outflow here, and hence there is no any pressure, even though commonly connected, no any pressure is being moved on towards this common connecting towards the pilot directional control valve, and hence entire the pressure which is generating by the initial motor that is being generating here itself. So for heavy load movement also this is very much help for moving the heaviest loads also. And in this way the extension stroke will be getting taken place, and at the extreme end of the extension stroke a limit switch is made on by the cylinder rod to break the solenoid circuit for the directional control valve F. That's nothing but after extreme extension there is a solenoid valve existing over here, and sensor that is our limit switch that is being placed over here. When this extension stroke connects with respect to the limit switch directly, the switch break down the connections at this particular F point, nothing but electrical circuit which is supplying will be getting cut off, and hence when it has been cut off the position will be getting changed here. Hence the here we are having the spring return conditions. If the pressure is being entering here, first position will be getting highlighted, and at this first position the fluid will be moving on here, and hence there is no any movement occurring at this particular junction level towards the pilot operated DCV, and the highest pressure of a fluid will be entering in the actuator itself, and forward stroke will be considering. And nominally after the complete extinction this pilot valve gives the signals to the F, that is nothing but the solenoid valve, and here the electrical power supply will be getting stopped. So when it had been stopped, already compressor spring which is holding the some particular tension or stress will be getting released towards the normal conditions. And at the normal conditions, this second position will be coming into the force. So at that particular situation, the that is a fluid which is having a lot of pressure, which is created by this pump, will be entering from P to A. So the P to A connection will be considering, or else T to B. This will be coming into the force from T to B, and next from this return directions. So it will be entering into the P to A, and will be entering here and commence the retraction stroke. Hence there is no any common connections over this. The fluid already entered while forward direction taking place will be draining back. So even in the draining condition also will be verifying once there is no any backflow. In the emergency condition, the pilot valve has been conditioned nominal in nature, then there will be any flow movement that is being occurring due to the high impartation. If there is any necessary, this motor which will be guiding over here and additional pressure will be entering into this, a common circuit will be getting generated, and upon this common circuit generation the additionally entering pressure will be getting released to the normal oil reservoir by the help of this pressure relief valve, and hence here there is no any backflow movement also being taking place because of there is no any connectivity, and non-return valve is opposing the passage of the fluid and it restricts, and there is no any alternative, and hence in the second position onwards it will be coming and draining towards the output channel, or nothing but the oil reservoir. Hence here the check valve is reversely positioned here, and at this situation the fluid will be allowed towards the oil reservoir conditions. So indeed to give the signals to the main DCV, this pilot DCV, which is existing within limit switch, after complete extinction at the piston end, when it meets the limiting switch conditions, it actuates the pilot valve, which gives the signals to the F from G to cut off the power supply, and hence this position towards the forward stroke will be getting stopped away, and the second position will be coming into the force. And nominally the imparted pressure which is pumping by the motor is being supplied, and hence the return stroke is being taken place. So there is a extension and retraction strokes that are being considered in the case of the automatic existing categorizations. So in the case of retraction, what will be the condition? In the case of retraction, automatic venting at end of the retraction stroke. So what will be the condition at the end of the retraction stroke? So extension is being considering. After the extension, immediately when the limit switch has been activated, it is giving signal to the pilot valve or else a solenoid valve indeed to change the position commonly. But at the return stroke, what will be the situations, will be having a detailed look once again. In the retraction stroke, at the extreme end of the retraction stroke, which the cam of the cylinder is operated by the rod, it is shifted the valve of G, present G. The relief valve vent port is thus connected to an E and G. So here E and G to the line of the gap end of the cylinder and to the tank through the F. The tank through the F, which is commonly connected through the F, and inline check valve C, that is draining towards the oil reservoir. So this vents the relief valve D and unloads the pump. Nothing but this vents this D will be an halting condition which allows the backflow of the fluid, and if there is any backflow also occurring in an heaviest pressurized conditions, this relief valve plays a major important role for its retraction towards the reservoir back. And this is the condition as we have been specified, that second position will be coming into the actuation, that previously have been looked at the forward considerations, and presently looking after the backward considerations, the pump of fluid which is being driven by the motor will be entering here and operates the safe pressure. If additional pressure is being entering, the sequence valve or pressure relief valve will be coming to the actuation for releasing of the excess pressure, and this fluid will be entering into a back port number 2, and completely extinction stroke of this particular rod will be moving for its back movement. Sorry, back movement, and already entered fluid will be drained back towards from the point B to T, and here the check valve is being attaining here, will enter the pressurized fluid back towards the reservoir. Here there is a common connection between the point B to G, and there is no any interconnectivity that is maintained by this pilot conditions. But all additional is required, these positions will be getting initiated with respect to this particular G. So when this pilot valve has been connected with respect to the cam, first port will be getting energized, and that will give the recoil of a back pressure. Just slightly it will initiate the back pressure because of the pressurized fluid which is having a common connection towards it will be coming into the force and enters from here. If this position come into highlights, this will enter and next back pressure will be getting set in the forward kind of stroke when it is solenoidally connected. So that will be getting retracted to its connection by the backflow moment of this hydraulic symbolic representation. This hydraulic symbolic representation, this backflow, it initiate and highlights the pilot valve closure or else the solenoid supply closure for this particular valve. And hence there will be supply stopping for in the forward stroke direction, and commonly the spring will extract towards its original characterization. The second position will be coming into the force and return stroke will be getting started. So this is a continuous process without any human involvement. For here, instead of happening the liver or mechanical mode of functioning, the electrical circuit plays a major important role here, that the extension stroke will give the signals by initiating this pilot valve or pilot switch and getting a feedback in the form of a back opposing signal towards the solenoid indeed to stop the signal. So hence there is no, if it has been replaced with the lever type of switch, there is no any requirement of this particular additional circuit here. So in the forward direction, when the lever is operated towards the left side direction, extension stroke will be taking place by supplying the important pressurized fluid to the circuit. And if the return condition has been maintained, nominally the return stroke will be considered and obviously it will be drained back towards the oil reservoir again. So the positions that is being changed without any human involvement. So liver transportation or else the liver supply towards the left and towards the right has been changed with respect to an solenoid control, and it automatically detects a limit switch feedback towards this solenoid connection directly, which creates and even which strikes the pressure. And even after completing the complete retraction stroke also, nominally it indicates the set conditions towards it. There is nothing but after completing the it is nothing but while extending the stroke, the limit switch will be getting activated. So in the retraction stroke, after getting to an retraction, that is a compressed strategy, piston to its extreme left to right edge, that is contracted position, retraction position, this switch will energize this pilot valve. So hence this pilot valve, when it has been arrived, this commonly the pressure which is being allowed here is there is no any connectivity here, and hence this continuous supply of a pressurized fluid by this motor to a sequence valve at a desired set pressure to the pilot switch. And hence upon the complete retraction position, this pilot section will compress this cam, and against this position one will be coming into the force. This fluid will be getting entered here, and next and common terminology that enters towards this solenoid control, and this switch will be again getting in on condition. So if this solenoid control or switch has been activated by this pilot valve, again it is the indication of forward stroke to be get started, and the solenoid valve supplies initiates the first position, this first position, and hence this position will be coming into the force, and again the previous actions, this is the circuit will be coming into the force again. So after that, extension will be taking place, and after completing this extension, this limit switch will be getting highlighted, and this will give the signal towards this solenoid control valve, and this supply will be getting stopped. At that particular situation, this circuit, retraction circuit, will be coming into the force. And this is the nominal forward and return stroke without any human involvement. Continuously, this is a cyclic process that will be going on, commencementing until and unless externally we have been altered that particular system. So there is a condition being taking place in the working environment. So this is the situation when it has been striking with respect to the camshaft. This is the condition will be coming into the position. The flow will be taking place, and excess flow will be getting restricted. And upon this condition, the solenoid will be getting into the switch on condition and off conditions. Push button start of the cycle, right? It will be getting started. And automatic venting at end of the retraction stroke also, it is taking place, obviously. So this is the functionality of this camshaft upon pressing, or else the pressure application highlights the DCV indeed to get switch on this solenoid supply for its forward stroke, and this is the retraction stroke just being at the end point of the retraction stroke, or complete extreme end of the retraction stroke. And again, this is the initializing step for the forward movement, and it start moving by leaving from the contact of this camshaft towards the limit switch. So upon complete extension, it meets the limit switch and hence initiate the back signal to this solenoid operated initial position to be get switched off. So it has been switched on in condition when its complete extension position has been taken place in the retraction stroke. So this is the strategy. It is automatically function without any human involvement. So moving on to the regenerative reciprocating system or circuit. The conventional reciprocating circuit is a four-way directional control valve connected directly to the cylinder. A regenerative reciprocating circuit, oil from the rod end of the circuit is directed into the cap. So nominally, it is a design criteria just we have been viewed recently. We'll be having a simple way of a circuit directly automatically regenerative with respect to solenoid supplies on the both the ends. Solenoid supply on both the ends if it is necessary, and a spring return constraint. So it is an only solenoid operated with respect to the hydraulic power supply generation, and this is a solenoid with respect to spring return, and next to the hydraulic circulated oil, and we'll be having an detailed core here. This is an oil reservoir, which when the pump has been switched on, the motor will pump the fluid towards the DCV for the actional scenario. And yet this particular situation, there is a common connection that is being maintaining over here, simultaneously maintaining here. The fluid enters here, and here this is a pressure relief valve. Additionally, entering pressure will be getting relieved by this, by the commencement of this actuation. And the set pressure will be entering into the situation when the first solenoid valve has been actuated. A has been actuated, P2A is connected, and forward stroke is getting maintained. And the fluid is get back directly towards the constraintary strategy, that is back flow from the B. It is getting obstructed at this particular situation because the same fluid which is being entered, which is being coming back, will be entered into the forward stroke due to the set pressure is being maintained here, which opposes the backflow at this common point. That imparting pressure will be getting executed towards the leaving out fluid, and that fluid which has been retracted back will be imparting with respect to the pressure that is being setting from this external way, and the same fluid will be getting entered into the forward stroke of direction. So nominally, the second condition, upon extreme right conditions, nothing but in the extension stroke, that is the extension stroke that is being taken place. After complete extension, the limit switch gives the signals, as we have been discussed in the previous circuit system. The feedback from the limit switch will be coming to this solenoid switch that to be deactivated. Point A is deactivated, and point B will be coming into the force, and this is the circuit we'll be considering. And P2B will be taking place, and P2B in the sense nothing but here the port number 2. The same will be commonly connected to the port number 2, and almost it starts flowing. That is nothing but this is the point B. The flowing will be considering from point B, and this is the B channel line maintained, and fluid will be moving on to this with the pressurized conditions, and pressure towards the point A will be getting stopped, and this will be coming back towards this strategy, and backflow of a fluid which will oppose the back pressure that is being entering from the basic motor from the pressure head. That same fluid which is being drained is being circulated towards the end of B, and retraction stroke also will be connected, and vice versa. After completing this point number, nothing but retractions, complete retraction stroke, here there will be a limit switch placed here. That limit switch highlights the B solenoid that retraction completely has been commenced. And obviously, that another one more signal that DCV will be driving that solenoid connection towards the solenoid A. It need to be switched on in condition for its commencement of activity. So hence it is a continuous process that is being taking place. Majorly, this is the strategy that is being followed in the reverse case of condition. So circulation is being taking place, right? In the circulation, there is no any extinctions, and draining fluid will be coming back towards the oil reservoir, and the entering fluid, which is maintained in circulation C, will be entering here, because when it is being entering, try to move towards the channel D also. There's no any connectivity here. At the same connectivity, it will be moving on to the next direction, and the reverse ways, it will be flowing towards the oil reservoir back again. So this is the strategy that is being followed in the reverse conditions, and hence this is called regenerative process. Automatically, it is being circulating the forward stroke and return stroke if the solenoid switches has been monitored with respect to the electrical power supply, and with that the concerned DCV will be getting in an actuation positions, and consequence of positions will be getting highlighted when extension stroke has been happened towards the solenoid A to stop the power supply, and B will be getting highlighted, and complete retraction B will be getting the signal, B will be giving the signal from the limit switch that it has been achieved towards the retraction position, and hence power supply is stopped, and hence for the commencement of next stroke, power need to be supplied for solenoid A. And this is the regenerative process, continuously cyclic process. It is a continuous cyclic process for both the extinction and retraction process. It is an unchanged until and unless the next condition has been came into the force. So next one, the sequencing circuits, and this regarding the sequencing circuits, I think the time has been expired, and we'll be seeing or looking after the sequencing circuits in the next class. Thank you.